So what's the deal with cholesterol? Is it important? Is it a big fat lie? Is it the most important thing that you've seen in healthcare? And what about all of the statin drugs? Is it good for you? Is it not good for you? What are the side effects? Well, that's what we're gonna cover in this video of what we can do to help with your cholesterol, your liver, your brain. Lots of good information, here it is. Something I get asked about all the time is about statin drugs, the side effect of a statin drug. And so what we're going to cover in this video is, what is a statin drug? Where does statin come from? What are natural treatments for statins? Because cholesterol is something that's really, really important, and I'm not sure it's the bad guy that most of conventional medicine says it is. Cholesterol is a waxy substance found naturally in the blood. It's predominantly produced in the liver, but it's also found in foods such as red meat, high fat cheese, butter and eggs. And cholesterol is essential for maintaining good health. Every hormone has to have a cholesterol structure that you can build the chemical messenger so that your body can communicate with itself. Cholesterol is kind of like blood sugar. If it gets too high, bad things happen. If it gets too low, bad things happen. And statins are a medically produced product. It's a class of drug that includes things like Lipitor or Zocor, and it's among the most effective drugs for lowering cholesterol. However, there's a ton of side effects. Now, these are some of the most widely prescribed drugs of all time, and like other drugs, statins have potentially serious side effects, and there may be instances in which they should not be taken. And so here's a rundown of things that you look out for if you're taking a statin, and at times when you should steer clear of the drugs altogether. Now, the first thing that happens with any type of elevated cholesterol is many times it's a lifestyle problem. People aren't putting the right things in their system, they're not moving enough, they're putting the wrong foods in their system, they're not getting enough water. So the cholesterol rage that is sweeping through the country for the last 20 or 25 years, the commonly prescribed medications include Lipitor, Pravacol, Zocor. The intentional effect is to lower the cholesterol, but here are some of the concerning side effects. Statins can cause muscle pain and soreness. It can cause leg pain, muscleized weakness, generalized pain and weakness, vomiting, stomach cramps, brown discolored urine caused by the breakdown of muscle cells being passed into the urine. And other side effects associated with statins include diarrhea, joint pain, cold symptoms, insomnia, urinary tract infections, nausea, increased liver enzymes. And so some safe alternatives to statins is to remember that statins do not treat disease. They simply lower cholesterol levels, and in the process, they block the production of a protective enzyme called CoQ10. In my opinion, the potential benefits of these drugs pales in comparison to their known dangers. Most of the time, elevated cholesterol is a lifestyle choice. If you choose things differently and you get out and you exercise and you move and you eat better, you can almost always reduce your cholesterol. And there is nothing, and I repeat nothing, that these drugs add to the program of cardiac prevention that can't be achieved with safer, less expensive, natural therapies, in my clinical opinion. High cholesterol is not a disease. It's simple. One of the risk factors that's associated with heart disease. And that's why when patients are taking statins and they come to the different clinics, they go to the Whitaker Institute, they go to the Mayo Clinic, they come to our office, our first order of business is to get them a reasonable alternative to a prescription-free lifestyle when appropriate. And when we start them on a multi-pronged program that reduces cholesterol, that increases energy, that reduces heart disease, and improve aspects of our health, they almost always improve. Their cholesterol comes back into healthy range. Now, lifestyle changes for a healthy heart begins with a diet that lowers the cholesterol and helps to quell inflammation and reduce. This includes a lot of fiber-rich vegetables, beans, legumes, a little bit of fruit, and plenty of lean protein, with an emphasis on things that help with healthy fats like salmon and tuna. Now, for extra fiber, you can add a quarter cup of fresh ground flaxseed to water, to smoothies, to salads, or to other foods to help improve your healthy fat. It's been known for a long time that exercise raises protective HDL cholesterol. But according to a 2009 study involving nearly 9,000 adults that don't move very much, it also lowers LDL, especially in women. And so our goal should be a minimum of 30 minutes of moderate physical activity most of the days a week. And for optimal results, adding 2 to 3 sessions of resistance training or weight training is really, really healthy. UCLA researchers found that when postmenopausal women followed this diet and exercise program for just 2 weeks, they had a significant improvement in HDL and LDL cholesterol, blood sugar, and body mass index, and a 45% drop in their C-reactive protein. It's a marker for inflammation. So lower cholesterol helps to suppress inflammation, which is really the cardiovascular disease. Now, in place of drugs, there's nutritional supplements, and for tackling cholesterol, we recommend plant steroids and a substantial increase in fiber, and most important, probably the B vitamin niacin. Now, what niacin does is it helps to not only lower LDL, but it helps to raise HDL, a feat no drugs is able to accomplish, and in fact, a Pfizer drug study aimed at increasing HDL was scrapped in 2007 after it was found that it worsens heart problems and increasing risk of death. But niacin, the story gets even better. Results from a recent clinical trial published in the New England Journal of Medicine prove that this supplement actually reverses blockages in the carotid arteries. For its broad cardiovascular benefits, we recommend that high doses of fish oil, EPA and DHA. Fish oil's primary omega-3 fatty acids reduces inflammation, it lowers blood lipids, especially the triglycerides, and it improves blood viscosity. It normalizes heart rhythms and protects against sudden cardiac death. Okay, to summarize what we can do about statins and statin drug alternatives. So the first thing that happens when you have any cholesterol concern, it's a sign of ill health. It means the liver's not working right. It means that we're not emulsifying and breaking down fats, that you may be eating too many junk foods, that you're not drinking enough, that you're not moving or exercising enough. And if you'll do those, you can really, really take a step in the right direction for cholesterol. Now, some of the neatest things that we can do from a natural perspective, and I like to use a company called Nature's NX, is you use a product called Low Ryer, which is red rice yeast. You can use Ultimate Omega or essential fatty acids, about 5,000 to 6,000 milligrams. You can use a product called Filter Flush that helps to filter out the liver. There are many options for cholesterol and cardiovascular concerns outside of statin drug therapy, but you need to take ownership of your health, put your body on a schedule, drink enough water, prayer, meditation, which is really good for all of your health all the way around. And those are some considerations for alternatives to statin and to be aware of some of the unintentional statin side effects. Hi, this is Dr. Jason West, and you just saw the video about statin drugs, what to do about cholesterol, your liver health, why it's so important for your brain. Remember, we're across all different platforms. We're always doing videos and reports. We want you to be able to use that information so that you can achieve and maintain optimal health. Please like us, and don't forget to click on the bell so you get a notification every time we see a new video, and I'll see you tomorrow.